This short video will explain how Bayesian weighting works. When traditional averaging is used, the rejection level needs to be set quite strictly in order to reject any excessively noisy sweeps that were above this rejection level. In this example, three individual sweeps have been measured. The first one is a good quality sweep, low noise, and so it was not rejected. The second sweep, however, has a lot more noise content, and is in fact barely acceptable, but still comes under the rejection threshold, so is accepted and included towards the overall averaged waveform. The third sweep has a lot more noise, has exceeded the rejection level, and is not included in the overall waveform. In this scenario, all of the sweeps are being treated equally. In Bayesian weighted averaging, things work a bit differently. The rejection level can be raised, as it is not as important. What happens here is that the excellent quality sweep is assigned a high weighting. The second sweep, which was barely acceptable previously, is now assigned a low weighting. And the third sweep is now also accepted, but assigned an even lower weighting. Those accepted sweeps now contribute a proportionately different amount to the overall averaged waveform, depending on the weighting that they have been assigned. In this scenario, the sweeps are being treated differently, depending on their individual noise content. And because of this, it is possible to raise that rejection level, and so there were fewer sweeps being rejected during testing. In traditional averaging, all sweeps are treated equally, and those noisier ones contribute just as much as the quieter ones. In Bayesian weighted averaging, low importance is given to sweeps with a lot of noise, and high importance is given to sweeps with less noise. It is important to emphasize that Bayesian weighting is not an alternative to a good patient state. It is still important for patients to be calm and settled and preferably asleep to minimize the amount of noise being measured. To show the effect of Bayesian weighting in action, here are two examples. In the top example, with traditional averaging in place, the residual noise increases when the patient becomes unsettled. Once they settle back down, the residual noise reduces over time. In the bottom example, with Bayesian weighting activated, when the patient starts moving, the residual noise doesn't increase. Instead, it remains stable and then continues to drop after the patient has settled. And for each of these examples, where 4,000 sweeps have been measured, there is a much lower residual noise level in the Bayesian weighting example than in the traditional averaging example. A much better quality waveform has been recorded in the same number of sweeps.